in, Deputy. Take a seat.
This won't take long.
While you've been in the field, we've had more reports about farmers being threatened and attacked. Unfortunately, some didn't survive. Not really, no. We can't be everywhere at once. Right now, our best hope to stop them is you. It's worse. It's tragic.
How's your investigation proceeding?
That's assuming he finds something useful. Otherwise, you'll be no better off than when you started.
It must be very easy for you to sit back and criticize when we've been doing all of the fieldwork.
I've done my part. Besides, this is Ranger business, so why don't you keep your mouth shut?
Let's move on. I asked the other Rangers to share their opinions of you. There are some things I want to go over. We'll start with Ranger Callow in Hopetown. She was grateful for your timely arrival and impressed you had the guts to take on those pirates. Nia says you were respectful with Ron Hope and didn't push too hard. That shows me you were listening when I said to go easy on him. Duty has to come before personal feelings. I'm glad you understand that.
Let's continue. We've got a detailed report from Ranger Price about your recent visit to Neon. He said you met an informant who asked for your help, but you talked him out of it. It might also have helped. You might have learned something new or gained a valuable contact. You should take every opportunity to lend a hand when someone needs it.
You got results, and that's what matters most. Price was impressed by that. Said you really took the initiative.
Ranger McMillan praised what she called your uncommon bravery and dedication. She said you took on the Red Mile so you could get a meeting with Marco Graziani. Sounds like you're starting to understand what it means to be a Free Star Ranger.
So what happened with Marco? I doubt he gave you that slate out of the kindness of his heart. I suppose underestimating you was his last mistake. Damn. I thought if anyone could see reason, it'd be Marco. What about Maya Cruz? Her loyalty to Hull and the First Cavalry was stronger than most. I guess I'd want the same thing if I were in her place.
Excuse me, Marshal?
Not now, Alex. We're in a meeting here.
I know, but this is important. I've done it. I've cracked the encryption on the slates. Now, I don't know exactly where the First are headquartered, but there are references to a place called the Factory.
The Factory? That was our nickname for the main facility where the mechs were manufactured.
Under the terms of the peace treaty, they shut all the mech factories down right after the war.
But they didn't destroy them. At least not all of them. Never saw it myself, but I know it's a large facility, mostly underground. If the First are occupying it, they'll probably have set up defensive positions throughout the complex. The facility was on Arcturus II. It could be a dead end, but if it's not, then you'd better be ready for a fight.
Be careful, Deputy.
Y'all got him, Deputy.
If you're looking for the Rangers, check the upper levels.
Proud to be helping the Free Star League. Late one night, Annie Wilcox tried to arrest...
The Rock isn't exactly massed, but as seats of government go, it's still quite an impressive structure.
Sure, Laredo. If you're looking for a weapon, I've got you covered. I'm sure I got what you need. Outlaws, just so you know.
up your hands, Scanner.
Captain.
I bet you'll find plenty here to catalog. These mechs were some of the deadliest instruments of war created by mankind. It's a relief that they've been outlawed by the Armistice. The people that inhabited this location left in a state.
Marshal Blake must be getting desperate sending a lone deputy out here. But I'll give credit where it's due. You're a hell of a pilot. You came here seeking justice. It's waiting for you inside.
Bring it on!
Set aside anything useful and just leave the rest.
I'm a man of action. I've got no use for lies. So when I tell you that you're being manipulated, you know I'm telling the truth. You think the Council of Governors really cares about anything but themselves? They're greedy and corrupt. Cavalry was the greatest fighting force the Freestar Collective has ever seen. At the Battle of Nera, the First Cavalry was destroyed. Why? Because the generals got scared and asked for a truce. I've got no sympathy for cowards or for the people who put them in power. I've also got no sympathy for those who do their bidding. And this means you.
valuable?
Some sort over here. You've got something for me?
I'd be happy to carry. Talk to you later.
Longer.
through.
Might as well take what we can. If you're searching them, make it quick.
going to end you!
Show me how to do it.
So, where to next? I have things for you.
Feel free to look around. Everyone needs supplies. Take a gander.
You're fluent in over 24 verbal and body languages.
Time to get back to the world, eh?
I heard that you're so fast, you can run around the planet and sign the back of your own head. We just need to find you a pen.
Fishing for a handout, eh? Maybe another time.
Thank you.
right arm to have a crack at those mech parts. I've heard they go for a fortune on the black market. This connects through to somewhere else. Believe the scope of the operation the FC was running here. It's a miracle that the fighting ended at all.
You just took on some of the best mercenaries in the Free Star Collective and cut right through them. If we'd have had more like you in the war, we could have planted our flag in New Atlantis. Not the way it should have. Of course, I can't expect you to understand what we sacrificed, what we lost. You don't know what it's like to look around and see the faces of warriors who trusted you to lead them as they die screaming. I watched brave men and women torn limb from limb by monsters. I saw mech pilots cooked alive in their cockpits as their machines burned. Those deaths didn't have to be meaningless, but spineless leaders gave up on us even when victory was within our grasp.
We've both seen our share of hell. It's whether or not we allow those awful memories to consume our souls that defines who we are.
You have no right to judge me! You really want to know? Because you might not like the answer. Last chance, deputy. You can walk away right now and remain blissfully ignorant, thinking you fight for a noble cause. But if you still want the truth, I'll shatter that illusion for you right now. We'll see about that. Not long after I started the first, I was contacted by a man who said he represented someone wealthy and influential. I refused to work for a shadow client, so he agreed to set up a meeting. Imagine my surprise when Ron Hope showed up. He offered me a lucrative contract to take possession of certain farms throughout Free Star space.
That's quite an accusation.
The credits were good, but yeah, getting some payback was the real reward. You think I've lost? Is that it? I haven't lost. You go find Ron Hope and tell him what I've told you. Then you can deal out whatever justice you see fit. You do your job, and I get one last piece of vengeance against the Council.
If what he says is true, then there's no question Ron Hope has to answer for what he's done.
Bother.
We're trying to take you in quietly. Violence is not the answer, Major.
I'm gonna make this easy for you, Deputy. I'm gonna die the way I lived. Weapon in hand, no compromise, no fear. But first, here, take this. Use it to cut out the weakness rotting at the heart of the Free Star Collective. When the next war comes, and it will come, the Collective needs to be strong. Now my unit's waiting for me, and I'm gonna report for duty one last time. Goodbye, Deputy.
Well, I suppose they're not going to need it anymore. Anything here you can use?
No one's home, eh? That's not necessarily a bad thing.